Hey you guys, it's Jobwise Jones coming right back at you again. It's great to see everybody. So today we've got a very serious topic I want to talk about, and that's addressing disrespectful behavior in your own clinic, meaning from other staff and other people, not the patients, actually your staff people, colleagues, co-workers, and so on, right? And so we really got to get down to these issues here because I want to get these things out because I get so many emails about this. Job-wise, how do I deal with my coworkers who are disrespectful? I've seen emails from about rude doctors, rude nurses, rude other medical assistants, and people like that. So you want to have something in place to address these issues, right? Right. Okay, so before we go on though, stay to the end of the video. I have a surprise for some lucky person out there, and you will see at the end of the video, so it's really cool. So you guys, this is a big issue, addressing these disrespectful behaviors in the workplace, and a lot of people don't know how to handle it, and a lot of people feel like they don't have any power, but you do have power here. I'll show you how you have power, okay? The first thing you got to imagine is all the people in your workplace, right? Whether some are rude, some are not, some are disrespectful, some are not. You're looking at how to address all of them to get everybody on the same page, right? You just cannot single out those people who are rude, don't care, you know, have no interest at all in being nice or kind. You have to address them all. So how do you do that? You do what we call a steering committee. So with that, you ask for volunteers, you post for volunteers, hey, let's get together and let's have a steering committee for behavioral issues. What that means is that people can volunteer onto this board that you can make up, or you can get the approval of management, HR, or whoever, and you want to get this as many people as you can on board with this idea, because believe me, if you have three or four people who are called sad sacks, so kind of, you know, they walk into work with a negative attitude right from the beginning, flat effect on their face, say, good morning, how are you, and that can be a doctor, nurse, or whoever, right? Those people are difficult to deal with. And then when you try to have a conversation with them, they always teeter on the edge of disrespect. No real clear-cut conscience in how they talk to you, and they don't care about anything. It's like they are tired of living almost, right? And so how do we get to these people, right? Steering committee, the first thing. You make up the steering committee, you get volunteers on that steering committee. Once that committee is established, you can establish this, you guys. You can do it yourself. You can be the one who's making it happen, right? It's harmless. No one's going to say no to a steering committee because they're good to have. Number two, you want to then, from that point, establish a code of conduct, meaning that you guys are going to make up rules for that office in which people who are disrespectful can be and will be called out. So what does that mean? Again, you're not trying to single out those people who are rude and disrespectful who are your colleagues. You try to make these generalized rules. It's like in America on the highway, right? A lot of people go way too fast. They go 95, 100 miles an hour, right? But the rule for everybody typically is 65 miles an hour. That's to address everybody. So the guys who are going 100 miles an hour down the road for no reason at all, except to look pretty cool, I guess, those are the clowns who get stopped by the police for endangering everybody else. And so when you establish a code of conduct for your steering committee, it's the same thing. You're bringing everybody onto the same level there. And that's when you start, you can say things like, okay, disrespectful behavior could be words that are bully words. What are bully words? You and the committee can figure that out, right? What are bully words, right? Words that show you a disrespect to fellow colleagues. What are those words? This is what I mean. A steering committee establishes a code of conduct in which you expect everybody, from the doctor, the nurse, or the medical assistants, this is everybody, you guys, okay? Story back in 1999, a doctor was there at this clinic for four years, very disrespectful, said sexist things and so on and so forth. He lasted for 2 years because what happened in the year 2000, one of the LPNs made up a steering committee, got her code of conduct going, and about a year later, he kept violating, boom, they knocked him out of there. Yeah, he made money for the clinic, but he wasn't worth the headache from the other 17 staff on there who were mostly female, who he was harassing sometimes and asking inappropriate questions, saying stupid things to them, or whatever, you know. An education does not mean you can go through life being an idiot to other people. It just means you have an education, okay? So anyway, back to what I'm saying. So you set up that code of conduct, and then you establish a communication strategy, meaning how are we going to have others communicate with others, you know? Meaning that you got to make sure people are not using bad words and bad behavior towards each other. That's what's about all about the communication. Now, these rules for the communication, for the code of conduct, comes from the steering committee, your volunteer board of people who work at your place, right? Then what you want to have is, you want to have a thing where you, a practice in place where you manage conflict, okay? Yeah, some people can go to HR for that, but also though you can also have a process where you manage conflicts. Maybe someone who can hear what's going on, an arbitrator, right? Someone who wants to hear what's going on. You can have maybe someone you can pick who's a really calm-headed person which we can talk to. Maybe immediately for managed conflicts, it goes to a supervisor, then it goes to a manager, or whatever. For those who are union, there's also union things in place already for conflict resolution, you know, to manage conflicts. But that's all about communicating to get these people on board who are being disrespectful, right? That's what it's all really about. The next thing you guys want to do, you want to have a way to establish interventions. This means that if you see someone having a hard time, because not everybody who's rude or disrespectful is a jerk, maybe they're having just a hard life, you know, having a hard time in life. Maybe they got divorced, maybe they lost their kids, maybe they lost a parent or whatever, right? And because of that behavior, they in turn are now what you would deem as disrespectful, but it could be because of a life event that is making them being disrespectful and maybe out of sorts. There you go. That's what I wanted. Maybe they're being out of sorts because they're having a hard life, right? Having a hard time, you know? I mean, it's tough. I've been divorced before, so it's very tough on you when you try to go to work and maintain some semblance of normality. It's very difficult, you know? So that is really cool because interventions mean you guys care about your fellow workers, right? And so interventions are great. So what does that mean? Well, the steering committee can figure that out. But typically what that means, an intervention is someone you trust or someone the person who you think is having a hard life trusts, right? Say Jan's having a hard time, but she trusts George over here. They're really close. They can ask George, can you just go see what's wrong with her and tell her we care about her? We want to help her. We're with her. We're behind her, you know? And then you stick behind that person, you know? I mean, some places are great. Some places you can even volunteer your hours, you know, your vacation hours to somebody to help them out. I mean, there's so many things you can do with this. But in the end, you're really trying to maintain your focus on eradicating disrespectful behavior from the workplace. And so this is all part of it, right? It's all part of it, you know? And so at this point, I'm going to stop and ask you guys to please subscribe to this channel. Don't just look at this channel and go on. Please subscribe to the channel, participate. I want you guys to grow in the JobWise Jones channel, the JobWise Jones community. 90% of my videos, and I have over 100 of them, are MA focused. Not many channels represent MAs like I do, so it's important we do this. So a real quick biography on me real fast. I was MA a long time ago for over 7 years. I then became a city planner. I got my master's in economics, a BA in urban studies. I became a city planner. Now I'm a hospital administrator. And so I'm still supporting MAs all the time. So that's my background. I think I'm a perfect person to represent MAs because I understand what it's like or what it was like. So I'm here for that, okay? Anyway, so also what you guys want to do with your steering committee, you want to train your staff. Bring in guest speakers, you know, bring in people from HR who can train staff on what to look for in clues and cues on people who are disrespectful, because people who are disrespectful, for the most part, are having issues that are outside the job, but they're bringing it into the job with them, and it's reflecting on everybody else, and they're like, you know, they're really making the black cloud in the office because of their behavior. Now, some people are just that way, right? They're what I call mistaken hires. And it's true. We do have sometimes a mistaken hire, meaning someone who excelled in their interview, but in the end, when they get hired, they're disrespectful because that's how they are, right? Some people are just that way, you know? They just don't understand how they should behave or don't care how to behave, and they are pariahs in the workplace, of course, you know? But most folks, you guys, seriously, most folks, you guys, are just having a hard life for that 2-3 months or whatever, right? And so this is what it's all about. Another thing you want to do if you train your staff, you want to really encourage the reporting of this, because reporting of people who are disrespectful, because you're not going to eradicate these people, you're not going to train these people, you're not going to help these people if you're not calling it out as it should be called out. And I don't mean being rude, like, hey, what you being so rude to me for? No, I mean, you call it out through the rules of the steering committee, right? You get your communication strategy going, you manage the conflicts, you know, you train your staff, and you come at them with some respect and care, even some love if you work with them every day, right? Because it's also your family, you know? People you work with is like a second family. So that's how you want to think about it. And the last thing, you guys, you want to create a positive environment at the workplace. So what does that mean, job-wise? Well, you guys will be amazed how many workplaces I go through. No one recognizes birthdays. No one has little potlucks at all. No one even has little cards to say, hey, thanks for what you did over here last Tuesday, whatever. People, look, you go to the job, you get paid. That's your role. I get that. You get money for services that you render to a job. I get that. But man, you know, if you just start a more creative, positive type environment, you'll be amazed how much more production a happier staff produces. And so you want to get that steering committee to think about things like creating positive environments. What can you do for that, okay? Now, you guys, this talk was about disrespectful behavior. But it really also, the underlying issue for me and my experience as a manager for many years is that most folks who are disrespectful have underlying issues that are there. And so by having your steering committee, by having some training, by having people look at it and call it out for what it is, it helps the person too as well who's involved with this black cloud of being disrespectful, right? It helps out everybody. So I guess what I'm trying to tell you is that as you're going through this process, just remember people who are in that situation, they're not bad. They're just having a hard time for that part of their life, okay? So that's it for Jobwise Jones. But wait, I want to share something with you guys. I'm an avid reader. I love to read. I have a TV on as background noise, but I rarely watch anything, you know? Oh, I did watch that Game of Thrones. That was cool. And I like that series, Preacher. Preacher's really cool. Well, for me, it's cool, you know? Anyway, so otherwise, I'm reading. I'm a nerd. I've been a nerd all my life. I like to read. I like to get lost in books, you know, and stuff. So it's really great. So what I wanted to do, you guys, I wanted to give you guys, now the first person, because I only got one of these books. I have one book I buy, and I don't buy them brand new. I go to a guy who sells books at his store. It's a really great store. They're used, but they're very good condition books. This is called Kitchen Table Wisdom. It's a really good book by Dr. Rimmon. And in this book are many stories about patients and her life and how she has dealt with things, you know, and so she's a medical doctor, which I know you guys can easily relate to her stories. And so here's the deal. For the first person that emails me at jobwisejones@gmail.com and says, hey, Jonesy, send me that book, I will send you this book for free because it's really, really cool. You know, it's a great book. It's one of my favorite books. And here she is in the back. She's really cool. Just a real humble-looking person, you know. So that's it, you guys. Send me an email and say, Jonesy, give me that book. And the first person who gives that email is the one who gets the book. Now, if I were a millionaire, I'd buy all you guys' books. But I'm not. I'm just a hundredaire. I have $100. That's all I got. So send me the email, guys. I'll send you the book. And you guys, please, and we're at work, you know, and you're thinking about the workplace and people who are disrespectful. I know it's hard, but try to have a little bit of sympathy for them or empathy for them, however you want to use that word. Just have some care about them a little bit. I've got two people I work around who are in this constant funk, you know, and we've helped out many times through our steering committee, and we've got some progress that's been made, but I've realized in time as I got older, I'm an older guy, in time, people are not trying to be jerks because they're jerks. People seem like jerks because they have a bad situation that they're dealing with, okay? All right, guys, this is Jobwise Jones. Please subscribe and comment for sure. And leave me a like and hit the bell for more videos. Thank you for supporting Jobwise Jones channel because we are really trying to represent medical assistants in the most positive way. Thank you very much, you guys. Bye-bye.